morning, everyone. I'm here to talk about my beliefs and my ideology. I proudly stand as a believer of religious freedom and basic equality for all men that reside in this nation. There is no law that can diminish equality, and America will be nothing without it. And so I, Thomas Jefferson, stand firm with these two distinct beliefs. I was born on April 13, 1743, in Albemarle County, Virginia. I lived on a plantation and was the third of 10 children. My father was a successful surveyor, so we were a wealthy family. I went to school at the College of William and Mary, where I loved studying and playing violin for many hours during the day. I later went on to study law by becoming an assistant to one of the local lawyers in my town. I served as a member of the Virginia House of Delegates and later on was the governor of Virginia. After being warned of an attack by British cavalry in my town, I fled, avoiding capture. I was ridiculed for being a coward and soon resigned as governor. I was also greatly concerned with the health of my wife, Martha. She died on November 6, 1782, during childbirth. We lived happily for 10 years. I was so distressed that I started writing my only book to get my mind off the tragic event. It was titled Notes on the State of Virginia. From 1785 to 1789, I was the American Minister of France. I enjoyed living abroad with my two daughters, Mary and Martha. I learned about the French Enlightenment and believed that it was a great movement that would benefit mankind. While in France, I communicated with colleagues back home about the creation of a new government, but I strongly insisted that a Bill of Rights was needed to make the government function well. Luckily, this was implicated into the government, and I considered it a major success. In 1790, George Washington asked me to be the Secretary of the State for America's administration, which I gladly accepted. I discussed government business with numerous groups of people, but I only had a budget of $10,000. I greatly admired Washington's bravery in battle and during political disputes. During the election of 1796, I lost to John Adams, who I despised greatly. Later on, in the election of 1800, I ran again and won. But I also made the purchase of Louisiana Territory, which doubled the size of the nation, and organized the expedition of Lewis and Clark during my two terms served. I soon retired to my home, where I love to work on architecture and gardening. I died on July 4th, 1826, the 50th anniversary of the signing of the Declaration. Coincidentally, John Adams passed away on that same day. My whole life, I tried to bring the idea that all men are created equal and that we should all have religious freedom as well. I believe that I fulfilled those beliefs with the Declaration and the passing of the Virginia Statute of Religious Freedom. I also designed the University of Virginia, one of the first colleges to not require students to have any certain religious background. I have faith that the future citizens of this nation will carry on the beliefs and set the standards for our country for the rest of the world to admire. I hope that I will be remembered for my success as a politician and a businessman. Although I have my faults, I feel my strengths greatly outweighed my weaknesses.